The inflation that has lodged itself in our economy is proving very hard to shift. So what can, or more to the point, what will the government do to address the issue? And what does that look like for you at home? With the Prime Minister off to Scott Base, Deputy Prime Minister and Finance Minister Grant Robertson is joining us this morning. Morena, Minister, how are you doing?
Kia ora, Matty. Well, thank you.
Good. It's tough out there, though, Minister, for a lot of people. Are you concerned by where we're at right now?
Look, it is tough, and you know, a lot of households when they go to the supermarket are really feeling that at the moment. And as a country, we can be pretty proud of how we've got ourselves through COVID, both from a health perspective and an economic perspective. But this inflation challenge is a global one. It's hitting everybody. You know, in the UK, they're up over 10%, in the US, up over 8%. We're just over 7%, and we look like we've peaked. And so there is some light at the end of the tunnel for people, but I don't underestimate how tough it is for a lot of households right now.
Yeah, and with all due respect, I think people were kind of past the point of caring about whether other countries are worse off than us. They kind of just want to know that things are going to get better here in New Zealand, because that's what is affecting households all the time. So is there light at the end of the tunnel, and what does that look like?
Yeah, look, I do genuinely believe there is. As I say, our inflation rate appears to have peaked now. We are continuing to provide support for households. For example, the cut to the fuel tax, that goes on until the end of January, half-price public transport's there. We've done big increases to people on fixed incomes, be that through working for families or be that through benefits, and we continue to look at how we can lift those rates to support people. So it is there. The Reserve Bank's got its job to do. It uses as the official cash rate to try and bring inflation down. It's the job we give the Reserve Bank independently to go and do that. So we're all working towards the same end here, but this is a global economic cycle. And I take your point, Matty. People aren't living in other countries, so therefore, that, you know, that's not their biggest concern. I guess the point I'm trying to make is, in the face of this global situation, I think New Zealand is as well positioned as anybody else.
Yeah, you mentioned inflation, and it's stayed pretty high at 7.2%, much higher than a lot of people were hoping or at least predicting with the September quarter. So what is being done to bring inflation down? What are you doing about it?
Well, again, the primary place within the broader government architecture to do this is the Reserve Bank. That's their number one job, and that's what they're focused on. So that's why they do what they do with the official cash rate. From our perspective, we're focused on trying to get to the causes of some of that inflation. For example, in the supermarket sector, we don't have a competitive supermarket sector here. New Zealanders pay too much for their food. So that's why you will have heard about the reforms that we're making there, making sure that new competitors can enter the market fairly and forcing the current duopoly we've got to work with them. So that's something that will make a difference over the medium term. In the shorter term, that's why we've provided that extra support to families and households to get through this. So it isn't something that's going to go away overnight. I absolutely respect and understand that. But just as we help people through COVID, we are helping people to get through this now.
We've been asking our viewers for their stories and for their concerns and questions for you as well, Minister. And I really like this one from Jane. She said, I'm currently 24 years old, first year teacher. In my head, I would have loved to have moved out of home by now and well on track to buying my first home, but it all feels hopeless. I feel like I'm scraping by and I'm struggling with all my other expenses. She said, what is his advice and your advice for people our age that are in the same boat? These people, Minister, who are doing everything they can to get by and feel like they're getting nowhere.
Yeah, look, and again, as I say, I'm not underestimating how tough it can feel for people in those circumstances. In the case of teachers, we've lifted those wages significantly over the last 5 years as well. When it comes to the building of housing, we are now building more houses than any government since the 1970s. But here's the problem, Matty. As a country, we didn't build houses for a significant length of time at the rate we needed. So when we came in 5 years ago, we were 60,000 houses short. You can't just fathom those up overnight. But we are building them. And so what I say to that person is, you know, keep doing what you're doing. What you're doing is the right thing. This is a tough period economically, but ultimately you've still got a great contribution to make to New Zealand, and there's still opportunity for you as we come through this tough time.
Although with so many of those measures, you know, in terms of housing, in terms of infrastructure, it so often feels like the horse is bolted. Like this, it's just impossible to play catch up after years of not putting the right amount of money into these things. Can you catch up? Can you catch up with things like infrastructure and housing?
Look, we do have to work really hard to do that. There's an old saying, Maddie, that the best time to plant a tree is 30 years ago and the second best time is today. I can't rewrite the history that's happened, but what I can do is put the level of investment that we are into house building. And actually, in a place like Auckland, the economists are now telling us that by the middle of next year, end of next year, supply and demand for housing in Auckland will start to meet in a kind of equilibrium. That'll take a bit longer in some other parts of the country. So we've just got to work really, really hard to keep building those houses, to keep providing support for people to get into those houses with first home grants and use of KiwiSaver and so on. But absolutely, the problem is because we didn't invest properly in that for a long time, it is taking us time to catch up.
Minister, really quickly, we had Helen Robinson from the Auckland City Mission on talking about the people that she's seeing through their doors and the concerns that she has for them. This is what she said to us. Can you listen to this?
I really want to encourage the government to look at the Working for Families package. So that is a tax credit scheme that really supports low-income families. Now, the threshold for that is very low before the abatement, so it's at just under $43,000 before it starts getting reduced. And really importantly, we want that Working for Families extended to families who are receiving benefits.
Is that something that you could do? Could you raise the threshold and could you give the Working for Families to people that are on the benefit?
We're actually doing a review of Working for Families right now, Maddie, and all of these issues are on the table. What I would say is that those who are on benefits are eligible for large parts of Working for Families. Helen's talking about the in-work tax credit, which people who are not working can't get. It's kind of in the name as to why that is, but we do understand the importance of supporting those who are on fixed incomes. There will be increases again to the rates of benefits. We now link them to average wages, so there will be more money coming in for those people, and we are doing that wider review to make sure that Working for Families is fit for purpose.
Minister, thank you so much for your time this morning. We so appreciate it. I wish we had longer to speak to you because there's a lot to talk about, but yeah, thank you for your time.